Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today is August 8, 2012 at 8:39 p.m. Eastern Time. Hey guys, those of you who've been watching me, as you know, right, yesterday, actually this morning I uploaded this video. It's called 60th Anniversary of Muckle vs. the Illuminati NWO Banksters, right? They have a draft. People, after I upload this video, right, I swear to you, as soon as I upload this video, within seconds, I got a phone call from the GPS monitor that's monitoring me. I got a call from them saying that they asked me if I tampered with my bracelet, right? And I said, no. They said, look at it. I look and all three lights was on, which means it malfunctioned. So they told me that to stay home. I couldn't leave in the morning. If I had to work, he said, don't go to work. Just stay home and when court open, call your PO and tell him that you need to get a new strap and your GPS. So I said, okay. And I told you all in this video, people, I was so tired, so I slept until like 10 o'clock. So I woke up and I called the PO. He answered the phone, talking about where you at. I said, I'm at home. Oh, well, we can't track you. There's no signal on you. I'm about to put a warrant on you. I said, so what do you want me to do? He said, well, you need to go get your strap. I said, where? He said, where you usually go? I said, where? We gotta go to so many different places. He said, go down to the Grafton Court. I got on there, people, and no one is there to help me. He didn't call anyone. He didn't try to help me. Is that this guy really? I don't know, man. It's beer. So anyway, I got help. This white lady, she's the chief assistant probation officer. You know, I had to go all over the place. But the point of the story is that they helped me. They put a new strap on my leg, and I called the GPS monitor, and I said to them, listen, people, before they put a monitor on my leg, right, I'm going too fast. Before they put the monitor on a new one, I called a GPS monitoring service and asked them, how come you cannot track me? They said, we could track you. I said, what my peer just told me, you can't track me. He said, yeah, we could track you. We know where you're at. I said, okay, so you need to call him and tell him to stop lying on me, because he's telling me that y'all can't track me, and they don't know where I'm at, and he bought a put a warrant for my arrest. He said, well, we could track you. So anyway, I was in the parole office. So the parole officer said, well, your peer didn't call you, so we don't know what to do. So I called the GPS monitor again. I gave the phone to the parole officer, and the parole officer spoke. They said, yeah, send him to the OCC. OCC, that building in Brockton, ready to do probation. So I went to the probation office and they told me, well, your peer didn't call. We don't know what to do. So the assistant chief, this white lady, came in and she said, I'll help you. So she went and got a kit, and she gave me a scissors, and she called the GPS monitor and said, I'm about to help Paul Muck. I'm about to cut this chap off his leg and put a new one on. Everything is okay. He's here. He's not tampering with this bracelet. So she gave me a scissor and told me to cut it off. So I cut it off my leg, and she put a new one on. Then I went outside and I called the GPS, and he told me, yeah, okay, just, we can't get the signal on you now, but stay outside for about 5 minutes, then call us back when the signal is come back on. So people, I went outside and I stood there for 5 minutes, you know, dodging the cops, because I know the cops, there was a warrant for me, so I don't want the cops to see me. So I'm dodging the cops and I'm outside. Then the signal came back on. So I called and I said, oh, Mr. Muckle, everything's okay. You're okay now. I said, well, can you call my PO and let him know everything is okay? They said, no, don't worry. We're going to call him. Everything is okay. So, people, I went home. As soon as I get to my freaking house and got inside, my phone rang. Who is it? The PO, probation officer. I said, everything's all right. I got strapped. He said, yeah, but they're the one for your arrest anyway. I said, what do you mean they're the one for my arrest? I said, but for what? He said, well, my supervisor told me to bring you in. So you need to get down here quick. I have a warrant for your arrest. You need to come and clear it up. So I called my attorney quickly, and my attorney said, I'll meet you down there. Don't worry, I'm going to meet you. You know, so we went down there. I went downtown, people, and there was no warrant. This guy, people, this guy, they know I'm about to fix it. I'm about to get a new strap. But yet they still put a warrant out for my arrest for no reason at all. So when he told me there was a warrant, He had already got the warrant, but it did not go in the system yet. They did not put it in the system, so the cops didn't know the other warrant for my arrest yet. Because it wasn't in the system. It was in transit. It was still on paper. They just had to put it in the computer, and they didn't get a chance to do it yet. So people, I beat them. Okay? I got the people of Boston. The court is like an hour away from my house. I live in Brockton now. The courthouse is in Boston, downtown Boston. I had to take a bus and all that stuff. I had to take a bus and a train. Two trains and a bus to get down there. But I beat them. I was running and I beat them. I said, I got to get there before these cops realize I have a warrant. Because once they arrest me, that's it. So I beat them people. I got downtown. The warrant was still on paper. It didn't even leave the court yet. It didn't leave the courtroom yet. So I beat them. And by the time I got there, they couldn't serve their warrant because I'm in the court. How can you serve a warrant for me if I'm sitting right there in your face with a GPS on my leg? So anyway, the point being, this is what they call. It say here, Boston Municipal Court Department for Criminal Business, name Paul Muckle, docket number August 8, 2013, type tape 18. My attorney name is Chamberlain. You know. Default taken off, no fee. See, GPS is fully functioning. $250 cash to August 22nd. Same recognition, PM 10. So you see, that's what they did to me, people. Put out this false warrant for my arrest for nothing, and I'm not even messing with the people. Why the hell would I tamper with my GPS when I know for a fact I'm going to go to jail if I tamper with it? I don't like jail. If I'm going to tamper with this GPS based on the idiots, I'm going to cut it off my leg and I'm going to disappear. You will never find me. If I cut my GPS off my leg, do you all think y'all could freaking find me? Y'all are so stupid. Y'all need to leave me the fuck alone because y'all are really pissing me off with this shit. If I cut this GPS off, you all I'll be on a plane. To Jamaica or to St. Kitts or wherever, y'all won't find me. So stop freaking messing with me. Okay? I'm not messing with this GPS bracelet. So anyway, my friends, this is it. I'm about to go to sleep. I'm tired as hell still. I'm still tired. You know, I'm exhausted, so I'm gonna leave you all with. I know y'all seen this already, but I'm gonna leave you all with it again. You know what I'm saying? One love, one heart, one destiny for all humanity. People, this is the devil's last throw, okay? This is not even... It's like the devil. Like, it's like they have some kind of machine that jamming this GPS. It's like they're jamming it, people. Like they're jamming it. They're jamming the signals to put me in trouble, but it's okay. Because I'm going to prevail. Anyway, people, I'm going to bed. I'm going to leave you all with this video. I know I left it with you all last time, but here's it again for those of you who didn't see it. Okay? One love.
...led to the threats of foreclosure.
But by acting as own lawyer, the homeowner convinced a judge that taking away his home would tear his family apart. Here's News Center 5's Amalia Beretta.
You want to grow up in this house?
Paul Muckle says his two small sons are two big reasons why he fought to keep the house he bought a year ago, a major fixer-upper.
Nothing was before the 1950s.
Muckle is a finished carpenter who is completely remembering his house himself. This spring, he says he suffered neck and back injuries in a car accident that kept him from working. He also fell behind in his house payments. He says his lender, the American Servicing Company, threatened foreclosure unless he agreed to a new, much higher mortgage payment.
My payments went from $2,064 to $3,800 per month.
Unable to pay, Muckle went to those calling for mortgage industry reform. But he says the governor's office and the attorney general's office turned him away.
It's like Chicken Little crying, the sky is falling, but no one is doing nothing to keep the sky from falling.
So Muckle went here to the Brockton Superior Court. Acting as his own lawyer, he was granted an emergency hearing to stop the foreclosure. He argued to Judge Jeffrey Locke that foreclosure is unethical because it is an assault on the American family.
A home is like you have a life of its own. And when you take that from somebody, you're killing their spirit. You know, you're killing them. When you take away home, you destroy communities. You destroy families.
Judge Locke ordered a stop to the auction of Muckle's home scheduled for tomorrow. The parties are due back in court in 2 weeks with a new affordable plan for Muckle. Attorneys for the lender did not return a phone call.
The message Paul Muckle says he wants to send to others facing a similar situation is don't give up.
He says if he would have given up, he would definitely have lost his home. In Brockton, Amalia Barrera, News Center 5.